In this proof of concept, an attack simulation was conducted on a Windows VM using Kali Linux in a safe and controlled environment. Both Iris and Splunk Enterprise were installed on an Ubuntu VM. Attack simulation. An SMB share on WS 2019 was accessed anonymously using SMB client, and the file user credentials.xlsx was downloaded. The file revealed credentials for the Splunk account. Based on this information, a list of usernames and passwords was created. A credential spray was conducted using NXC SMB with these usernames and passwords, which revealed that the domain administrator account was using the same password. A Kali machine hosted setup.exe on an HTTP server containing a reverse shell payload. A phishing email impersonating IT support was sent to a user containing a link to the Kali machine. Clicking the link triggered the download of setup.exe. With the listener setup on Kali machine, the setup.exe was executed, establishing a reverse shell. Next, the previously obtained credentials were used with PSExec to gain system-level access. Introduction to Iris, adding a customer. Log into Iris as an administrator, navigate to the Advanced section, and select Customers. Click Add Customer. Name the customer cyber.local and include customer as a brief description. The service level agreement field can be left blank. Click Save to create the customer. The new customer will then appear in the list on the customer management page. Creating a case. Go to the dashboard and click Create New Case. Select cyber.local as the customer, enter date and data breach as the case name, choose information content security, unauthorized access to information as the classification. Add data breach from unauthorized SMB share access as the short description. Click Create to add the case. The newly created case will appear under attributed open cases. Adding assets. To add an asset, navigate to the Assets tab and click the Add Assets button. Add a new asset with the following details: asset type as Windows DC. Set name as WS 2019 and description as Windows Server 2019 Domain Controller. Set domain as cyber.local and IP as 10.0.0.140. Set compromise status as compromised and analysis status as done. For asset tags, enter Windows and domain controller and click Save. Add the second asset. Select Linux computer as the type. Enter Splunk as the name and provide the description. Enter the IP address. Mark the compromise status as compromised and set the analysis status to done. Add the tags Linux and Splunk, then click Save. Add the third asset. Select Windows account AD. Set the name to Splunk and add the description. Set the domain to cyber.local. Mark the compromise status as compromised and select Done for the analysis status. Add the tags Windows, Active Directory, and account. Click Save. Add the last asset. Select Windows account AD admin as the type. Add administrator as the name and add the description. Set the domain to cyber.local. Mark the compromise status as compromised and select Done for the analysis status. Add the tags Windows, Active Directory, and administrator account. Click Save. Our list of assets now contains a total of 4 entries. Creating a timeline. To locate the log for the first event, search the Splunk using the following query. Set the time frame to all time to ensure the event is captured. On Iris, navigate to the Timeline tab and click Add Event. Enter the title, date, time and the UTC offset. Add the description. To obtain raw event data, return to the Splunk, select Event Actions and then Show Source. Copy the highlighted log and paste it into the raw event data field. Set the event source as Sysmon. Add the event tags as File Creation, Firefox, and Setup.exe. Link the event to the asset WS2019 and select Category as Initial Access. Select Add to Summary and the red as a color. Click Save. The newly created event is now visible. To locate the log for the second event, search the Splunk using the following query. Set the time frame to all time to ensure the event is captured. Add the event on Iris. Add event title, date, time, UTC offset, and the description. Copy and paste the event raw data from Splunk. Set the event source to Windows Event Log and add the tags Anonymous Login and SMB. Link the event to the asset WS2019 and categorize it as Initial Access. Select Add to Summary and assign an orange color, then click Save. To locate the log for the third event, search the Splunk using the following query. Set the time frame to all time. Add the event on Iris. Add event title, date, time, UTC offset, and the description. Copy and paste the event raw data from Splunk. Set the event source to Windows Event Log and add the tag Malicious Service. Link the event to the asset WS2019 and categorize it as Persistence. Select Add to Summary and assign in green color, then click Save. After saving, the Timeline tab displays the newly added event, bringing the total to 3 events. Adding evidence. The following is the content of the raw phishing email. To add this as evidence, go to the Evidence tab and click the database icon. Click the plus icon next to the evidence folder and select Add File. Browse for the email file, add a brief description, and include the tags phishing and malware. Select File is evidence and click Save. The file appears in the Evidences folder within the data store. It is also registered as evidence with its corresponding SHA-256 hash. Collaboration and Access Management. To add a comment, go to the Timeline tab and click the speech bubble icon in the upper right corner of the event. Multiple comments or questions can be added here, simulating a chat. Tasks can also be created and assigned. To do this, go to the Tasks tab and click Add Task. Assign the task to Administrator, set the status to To-Do. Add the title and description. Add the tags Malware and Reverse Shell. Click Save to add the task to the list displayed in the Tasks tab. To manage user access, navigate to the Advanced drop-down in the sidebar and select Access Control. Here, users and groups are displayed as the main permission entities. Select Administrator and navigate to the Cases Access tab. We can see that the administrator has full access to the data breach case. Generating a report. Go to Advanced in the sidebar and select Report Templates. Click Add Template. Upload the template file. Set the template name and type to Investigation and the language to English. Put Investigation as the description, use case name and date for the name format. Click Save. Open the Investigation template using LibreOffice. On the cover page, there are tags corresponding to the case name, document ID, and date. The assets table is generated using a for loop. To generate a report, navigate to the Summary tab, click Generate Report. Select the investigation template and click Generate. Open the downloaded report to see the placeholders replaced with actual data. We can see the case name, document ID and date. The asset list was similarly updated, with the for loop populating the table with four rows, each representing the created assets. Case closure and database backup. To close the case, navigate to the Summary tab, click Manage, then Edit, and select True Positive with Impact as the outcome. Choose Close Case, click OK to confirm, and the page will update to reflect its closed status. To create a database backup, start by identifying the container ID where Iris is running. Next, use the container ID with the docker exec command to backup the database. A database backup can also be created directly from the Iris web application. Navigate to Advanced, Server Settings, Backups, Database, then click Backup Database. In this proof of concept, we demonstrated how an attack simulation integrates with Iris to streamline incident response. From adding customers and creating cases to managing assets, timelines, evidence, reports, and case closures, Iris simplifies the entire process. We also covered database backups to ensure data integrity. Iris empowers efficient and effective incident management, making it an essential tool for cybersecurity teams. For more details, refer to the Cyber Defense Kit documentation.